We are around an hour away now from Aussie tennis legend Lleyton Hewitt's official induction into the International Tennis Hall of Fame. The former world number one will become the 34th Australian to become a Hall of Famer. Lleyton spoke in Newport in the US, where the ceremony will be held.
Yeah, well, it's pretty surreal, to be honest. It's never something I ever thought about as a player.
If someone had asked you at the age of 8, 9, 10, maybe they did, what do you want to be when you grow up, would you have actually said a tennis player?
Not at that stage. I wanted to be playing for the Adelaide Crows at Football Park, playing AFL football. I was taking tennis seriously, but at 14 I had to make a decision. Yeah, obviously I think I made the right choice.
He sure did. Hewitt now joins the likes of Rod Laver, Stan Smith and Andre Agassi on the honours list.
Welcome back to Weekend Today. We are less than an hour away from Aussie tennis superstar Lleyton Hewitt being officially inducted into the International Tennis Hall of Fame in the US.
Live now to our correspondent Amelia Adams. Millie, good morning. A big weekend for the former world number one.
Oh, a huge weekend, Charles and Belinda. Good morning. And just a huge honour, Lleyton Hewitt, to become the 262nd Hall of Famer and the 34th Australian to be inducted. He'll take his place in history alongside the likes of Todd Woodbridge, Pat Rafter, Yvonne Goolagong, Margaret Court. And it is certainly well-deserved when you look at his resume, his incredible career. Wimbledon champion, US Open champion, two-time Davis Cup champion, you mentioned, former world number one, 30 individual singles titles. So this weekend, the 41-year-old has returned to Newport, Rhode Island, here in the US, where he will be inducted into the Hall of Fame. And that's actually where he won his first victory on grass when he was just 17 years old. And as you might expect, Lleyton Hewitt's been reflecting on some of the highs and lows of his career, as well as some of the big challenges and personalities on the courts over the years.
I think the toughest challenge in tennis is playing Rafa at the French Open. Yeah, I think that is the toughest challenge that I've ever been part of or ever experienced. Roger Federer could nearly play the perfect match, I think, on most surfaces, especially grass or hard court. But I think playing Rafa on centre court at the French Open, it's pretty much proved itself with how dominant he's been at that particular tournament.
Yeah, incredible to think he was only 15, Lleyton Hewitt, when he stepped into the spotlight playing a 15-year-old Roger Federer, as he just mentioned, in the Junior Davis Cup. And since then, he's given us so many incredible performances and all those big come-on moments, a real combination of obviously physical talent, but also the work ethic and determination. And today, Lleyton Hewitt was asked what he'd like his legacy to be. And he said he wants to be remembered as a player who really gave everything and left everything on the court, played with his heart on his sleeve, and was very proud to represent Australia. And he certainly is all of those things, yeah. Charles and Belinda. He's got his wife and three kids there today, his dad, his former coach. It's going to be a huge celebration as he joins the ranks to receive the sport's highest honour.
His oldest son's quite a tennis player as well.
Ooh, on the it's up. In the genes.
Cruz Hewitt, I think, from memory. So look out for that.
That's
one.
That's right.
I think there'll be a few of these today as well, don't you reckon?
These ones, come on.
Come on. Yeah. Is that it? I'm going to get it wrong.
Yeah. Hannah, that one.
This way.
Happening right now, Aussie tennis legend Lleyton Hewitt is, as we speak, being inducted into the International Tennis Hall of Fame in the United States. Live now to our US correspondent, Amelia Adams. Amelia, this is a huge honour.
It is a huge honour, Jane, though certainly not a surprising one when you look at Lleyton Hewitt's stellar career. He burst onto the court at the age of 15, the boy from Adelaide, and went on to become Wimbledon champion, US Open champion, world number one, a Davis Cup champion. He's made a huge contribution to the sport in Australia and around the world. So as you say, right now, Lleyton Hewitt, after a bit of a delay because of COVID travel delays and whatnot, he is taking his place in tennis history at a ceremony in Newport, Rhode Island, here in the United States. And he says that all of his success has really come down to combining, obviously, his sporting talents on the court, but a lot of hard work and determination.
Well, I gave 100% every time I stepped on the court, and it wasn't just the match court, it was the practice court as well. And, I felt like, obviously, training with the likes of Tony Roach, every time I stepped on the practice court, it was about having a purpose. It wasn't just going out there to hit balls over a net.
Yeah, he's the 34th Australian to join the ranks, so pretty impressive, alongside some of the big names, Margaret Court, Todd Woodbridge, Pat Rafter. And there's a big celebration underway. Lleyton Hewitt's got his family there, his wife and kids, former coaches and whatnot, as they pay tribute to some of those great come on moments, Jane, that he has given tennis fans right around the world over the years.
And we have some new pictures for you now at 9 of Aussie tennis legend Lleyton Hewitt officially being inducted into the International Tennis Hall of Fame in the United States. The former world number one was honoured with messages from other Aussie tennis greats before he took to the podium himself.
I feel fortunate that I was able to play across different generations, that I was able to be on the same court as my heroes that I looked up to, like Andre Agassi and Pete Sampras, and then go on and compete against three of the greatest tennis players our sport has ever seen in Roger Federer, Rafael Nadal and Novak Djokovic.
Hewitt is the 34th Australian to become a Hall of Famer, joining the likes of Rod Laver, Stan Smith and Andre Agassi on the honours list.